Hi everyone, so welcome to another surgery lecture video. Today we will discuss about wounds. You see, wounds is a very big chapter, so we will cover in three lectures. First one will be the wound types, next will be wound healing, third will be the treatment. We will cover the standard treatments and the recent or advanced treatments. Okay, wounds is a very important chapter for students, okay, because long questions and short notes will come from this chapter. The wound types and the wound healing is a long type questions, or you can get as like the closed wound or the open wound like short note questions, and it is even more important for field vets, okay, especially the wound types. Okay, wound types is a very important chapter for field vets, because you see, in veterinary legal cases, okay, when someone has stabbed or someone has beaten the animal, you have to specify the wound types, which types of wounds, and you have to give the measurements also. So you should know the different wound types. Also, these wound types will help you in treatment. Okay, so now let us start the wound types. First lecture, the wound types. You see, I have mentioned here traumatic. You see, there is nothing called traumatic wound or surgical wound. We will discuss in two heads, the traumatic wound and the surgical wound, but there is nothing called the traumatic wound or surgical wound, no classification. For your better remembering or better remembrance, I am citing this, okay. So don't search in any book, you may not find this. Okay, the first one, the traumatic wound. Okay, the wounds are basically classified as the closed wound or the open wound, depending on the breach in skin, whether the skin is breached. They are being classified as the closed wound and the open wound. In closed wound, there will be no breach in skin, while in open wound, there will be loss of continuity in skin. Okay, so closed wound are basically caused by the blunt objects. For example, sticks, okay, they are basically blunt object. While the open wound is basically caused by the sharp or pointed objects. You can give examples of like glass, knife, sword. And the sword is basically not being used now. But you know, in Japanese movies, like the, if you are a yakuza, you will use sword. So sword, knife, glass, or nails, like that. Okay, the sharp or pointed objects. So this is the closed, difference between the closed and the open wound. Okay, now we will come one by one. First, the closed wounds. You see, this is a drawing. Okay, this layer is skin, S for skin. SC for subcut, this is subcutaneous tissue, this is muscle, this is body cavity, then the other side, the muscle, subcutaneous and the skin. Okay, you see, in there is a lining, attached to the muscle. In case of abdomen, it is known as the peritoneum. While in case of thoracic cavity, it is known as pleura. Okay, in the other side also. Okay, so you remembered the structure. Now we will discuss one by one. You see, this is a cross sectional view, this is from dorsal view, or you are looking at the wound, how they will look. Now first, the breach. What do you mean by breach? In breach, there will be the capillaries of skin will be affected. Okay, this only, there will be breakage in capillaries of skin. So there will be a reddening of skin only. Okay, so how it will look in the dorsal view? Like this. Okay, you will find a red patch. Okay, next, contusion. In contusion, the skin and the subcut will be involved. Okay, so this is contusion, but from above point of view it will look like same. Okay, but remember the pain in contusion is more than the bruise. Next, hematoma. Hematoma is basically accumulation of blood in a cavity. It is usually in subcutaneous spaces. Okay, from above the skin it will look as same, like the bruise and the contusion. Okay, but difference is in hematoma you will mostly find a fluid. Okay, you can feel the fluid by physical examination. Okay, but bruise and contusion, they are more or less same. You can say bruise as a mild contusion. Okay, they are more or less, and the color is usually red if it is fresh, or it may turn bluish or purplish. Okay, remember this. Okay, from above the structure you may find this coloration. Okay, and if the skin is not bleached, then it may be a bruise, contusion or hematoma. So this ends the closed wounds. Now the open wounds. Now the incised wound. Incised wound usually is caused by sharp objects. So incised wound, okay, it will look like this. You can better appreciate here how they usually look, the incised wound. The thing about the incised wound is the even edges. Okay, but in lacerated wound, this one is lacerated wound, you will find an uneven edge. It is like someone has torn the skin. Okay, that is why the name, the lacerated edge. So you can remember these two wounds, incised and lacerated, on the basis of the edges, the wound edges. Okay, on the basis of wound edges you can classify the open wound as incised or the lacerated. Okay, the incised you will find even edges, where in case of the lacerated you will find uneven edges. Okay, now these three, the punctured, penetrating and the perforating, these three wounds are basically classified on the basis of the layers penetrated. Okay, now first the punctured wound. What do you mean by punctured wound? In punctured wound there will be a small opening. Okay, it's like a nail puncturing. It may reach up to the muscle, but it never communicates with the body cavity. Okay, remember this one. It never communicates with the body cavity. This is a punctured wound. Remember, in punctured wound, you can give best example as a nail puncture. First of all, is a nail puncture. Second was a bite injury. You know, dog bite injury. In punctured wound, you see there is no space for drainage. There is a very small opening in from surface. It will look like a very small opening. Okay, this is punctured wound. So due to less drainage, usually they tend to they are more prone to infections. That is why most of the time you will be hearing from seniors, in case of dog bites, usually they do not do stitching or suturing. Okay, because if you will suture this one, as there is no drainage, the infection will spread up. Okay, that is why even in some cases we will have to give more drainage by incising the wound. Okay, so remember the punctured wound. Okay, next the penetrating wound. In penetrating wound, it is same like punctured wound, but the thing is it communicates with the body cavity, whether the abdomen or thorax. Okay, this is a penetrating wound, but from above surface it will look as of the punctured wound. Okay, this is penetrating wound. Next, perforating. What is perforating? Perforating, in perforating wound there will be an entry point and exit point. You might have seen in movies, okay, when the bullet passes, it has an entry point and an exit point. It doesn't mean all the bullets pass through it, but many of the bullets have an entry point and an exit point. This is known as the perforating wound. Okay, so you learned the difference between the punctured, penetrating and the perforating. All the wound will look same from the above, but thing is they are penetrating layers. Okay, remember, for punctured wound it will go up to the main, go up to the muscles, but never communicate with the body cavity. While in case of a penetrating wound, it will communicate with the body cavity. In perforating wound, there will be a, this one is entry point, this is a exit point. Okay, in books you may find a synonym, they usually use in interchangeably the perforating and the penetrating. Okay, next, these two, abrasion and avulsion. This is basically classified on the basis of tissue loss. Okay, first the abrasion. What is abrasion? There is loss of epidermis or some part of dermis. You know, in Odia, molichoma uthi jiba. So this is abrasion. Okay, but avulsion, there will be actual loss of tissue. The it may up to the muscles, there may be some avulsion of tissue. That means some actual tissue is lost. Okay, from above it may look like same, the abrasion, but thing is the layers you may appreciate by physical examination. Okay, so this is abrasion and avulsion. Next, the granulating and ulcerating. The granulating and ulcerating wound are basically classified on the basis of tendency to heal. Okay, the granulating wound is also known as healing wound. Okay, if you will find any granulation tissue are usually red in color. Okay, if there is any wound and you find a red color mass in wound, it is healing. Okay, that is why it is known as granulating. When I will go for the wound healing, you will know the importance of granular tissues. Okay, so granulating wound means there is tendency to heal, or the wound is healing. Okay, from above this is the wound and you may find the granular mass. It is usually bright pink or red in color. Okay. Next, ulcerating wound. Ulcerating wound doesn't have any tendency to heal. Okay, you can say there's a chronic wound. Okay, usually the color of the ulcerating wound is black, or you may find dead or necrotic tissues, blackish white. Okay, you may find dead and necrotic tissues. These are basically the ulcerating wound. From above, it is same as the granulating wound, only the color is little blackish or whitish. Okay, so this is the classification of wound. Again, the revision. Okay, the wound is classified as closed and open on the basis of breach in skin, whether skin continuity is lost or not. Okay, the closed wound is basically bruise, contusion and hematoma, while the open wound, you remember on the basis of classification, on the basis of age, it is incised and lacerated. Whether the layers are penetrated, on the basis of layers penetrated, punctured, penetrating and perforating. Punctured is up to the muscle, it does not communicate with the body cavity, while in case of penetrating, it communicates with the body cavity. In case of perforating, there is the entry point and the exit point. Next, on the basis of tissue loss, abrasion and avulsion. Abrasion is basically loss of epidermis or some part of dermis, while in case of avulsion, there is many tissues are lost, maybe skin, subcut or muscle. Then on the basis of tendency to heal, the granulating and the ulcerating. So granulating, you will find a red color mass or red color granular tissue which shows the tendency to heal, while in case of ulcerating wound, you will find a dark black or a whitish tissues which are basically dead and necrotic tissues. So this is all about the open and closed wounds. Remember, in case of vitrolegal cases, you have to identify or you have to write in your report which type of wound is this. Remember, while giving a report, you see in a wound, this is length, or you can take this as a length also, but the longer one is length and the shorter one is breadth. Okay, you have to give the length of the wound, the breadth of the wound and also the height or the depth. Okay, in vitrolegal cases, you have to write all this and also which type of wound is this. Okay, in vitrolegal cases, it's very important. From the edges, for example, someone has stabbed a sharp knife. Okay, you will find the incised wound. Okay, suppose there are some knives which comes as a sharp edge on one end while the other is a rough. So when that will be stabbed, it will come as some part will be incised wound and the other part will be lacerated. Okay, from that the instrument can be known. This is forensic science actually, but thing is you have to write in your vitrolegal cases. So this is all about the closed and open wound. Let me discuss about some other types. See, acute and chronic wound. The acute wound and the chronic wound. You might have heard this wound is very chronic. So when you will say this is a chronic wound and when this is the acute wound. The acute wound basically heals within 3 weeks. If a wound heals in 3 weeks or 21 days, you see this 21 days is very important, you know. If you have to take a new habit, you have to perform it for 21 days. If you have to leave a habit, then for 21 days also, you know, quota factory, if you have washed quota factory, you might have known. So 3 weeks is acute. Well, if it takes more time in months, like 3 months, then this becomes a chronic wound. So this is basically acute and chronic, nothing new. Next, the burns and scars. You see, this is a separate chapter in a very small chapter in, you may find in Essentials of Veterinary Surgery by Eben Gopalan. The burn wound is basically caused by fire or heat, dry heat basically, while the scalding or scald is caused by moist heat. It may be steam or the hot liquid. Okay, the burn wound and the scald wound. This is also important in vitrolegal cases. You have to give how much percentage has been burned or how much percentage has been scald. So remember, while giving the vitrolegal report for burning or scalding, you have to give it as a percentage burn. Percentage burn or percentage scald. So while giving percentage burn or percentage scald, usually it is eye estimated. Okay, but the thing is, if you go scientifically, you have to measure the body surface area and how much is burned. So you have to give percentage. But while writing your vitrolegal level, most of the time it is eye estimated. But write in bracket that it is eye estimated. Okay. This is very essential. Because it is a legal case, we have to write your report carefully. Now, in Bowman's card, there are 3 degrees. Okay. You can say first degree, the second degree, and the third degree. So, which one is first, second, third? In first degree, the only skin is affected, this much percent. In second degree, the skin and subcutaneous tissues are affected. In third degree, the skin tissue, subcutaneous tissue and the muscles. Remember this one, the first degree, second degree and third degree burn. In a report, you may write whether it is a first degree burn or second degree burn or third degree burn. Okay, but this comes as a long question for students, in your examination, especially you know when you will start the principles of surgery. Okay, so this comes as a long type questions, or it may come as short note as only open wounds. Okay, so this is all about traumatic wound. Now we will go for the surgical wound, the wound created by performing surgery. So now coming to the surgical wounds. Okay, so wound created by surgery. So first one is a clean wound. Okay, what do you mean by clean wound? It is basically the operation procedures in which the respiratory tract, the gastrointestinal tract or genitourinary tract is usually not entered. Okay, you do not give incision into these systems because most of these symptoms contain infected materials. Okay, so the infection rate in case of the clean wound is usually 0 to 6%, not 0.6, 0 to 6%. For example, which operations is usually a clean wound surgery? The elective OHE, pyometra is not a clean surgery, but the elective OHE, this surgery is a clean surgery. I am giving the common examples. Now, the clean contaminant. What do you mean by this? You will enter these tracts, okay, but there won't be any spillage. Once there will be spillage, it becomes contaminated. When you will enter these systems, it becomes partially contaminated. That is why the clean contaminated. The infection rate is usually 4.5 to 9.3%. So, which surgeries are basically the clean contaminant? You see, enterotomy is a clean contaminated surgery. Cystotomy. Is a clean contaminated surgery. Cholecystectomy, removal of gallbladder. Ectomy means removal. Okay. Cholecystectomy. So these are basically the clean contaminated surgery or clean contaminated wound. Next, the contaminated wound. You will enter these tracts and there will be spillage. Suppose you are doing a urolithesis operation or you are doing some enterotomy or intestinal resection. There is every chance it may spill, okay, the intestinal contents or the urine. So once there is spillage, wound will be contaminated. You see, the infection rate is usually higher. The infection rate may vary from 5.8% to 28.6, near 30% increase. Okay, so in these cases, I am giving an example. I did a C-section few days back. Okay, while removing the fetus, okay, some of the uterine fluids went into the abdomen. That is the contaminated surgery. So, in case of contaminated surgery, you have to take necessary precautionary steps, okay, before closing the wound. What I did in case of this C-section, I placed a Foley catheter okay, under the abdomen just behind the umbilicus. Once I placed the Foley catheter, all the spillage, that is the infected materials, were drained out by this Foley catheter, and the regular washing through the Foley catheter reduced the infections, and the cow survived. So while doing the contaminated surgery, when you know there is spillage, okay, so take necessary steps to avoid the infection. You see, I am telling the IR because of this. In case of clean surgery, you may not need any prophylactic antibiotic. Okay, you may start antibiotic on the next day. Okay, if you have done the surgery very nicely or very perfectly, you may not need the antibiotic on the same day or prophylactically. You may need antibiotic on the next day. Okay, but in case of clean and contaminated, there is some infection, it may start on the same day. But in case of contaminated surgery, if suppose a C-section which comes after 3 days, okay, 72 hours, that is going to be a contaminated surgery. So you have to give antibiotic prophylactically. Okay, you should know when to give the antibiotics. Okay, so this is contaminated. Examples are, I already told you, a C-section. Okay. Late C-section, okay, early C-section, if you are doing very perfectly, it may not be a contaminated, it may be a clean contaminated surgery. Next, the complications of enterotomy and cystotomy, the urolithiasis operation, or systolith actually, not urolith, the systolith operation. Okay, there is spillage of urine, or you are doing intestinal resection. If you are doing perfectly, it is a clean contaminated surgery, but there is spillage. If there is spillage, it becomes a contaminated surgery. Okay, the last one is a dirty wound. Okay, it is already infected. If you perform this surgery, it is already infected. Best example is abscess, opening or abscess. That is a dirty surgery or dirty wound. Once you open an abscess, the fluid itself will contaminate the wound. Okay, so this is a dirty surgery. In case of dirty surgery, you will find purulent discharge like abscess or devitalized discharge. In abscess, you will find both this. Okay, the best example is abscess. So this is all about the surgical wounds. Okay, the four types. Remember, first one the clean, the opposite dirty, then clean contaminated and the contaminated. Okay, clean contaminated, contaminated and dirty. These four types are basically the surgical wounds. Okay, remember, I already told you there is nothing called surgical wound and traumatic wound. For your better remembering or better remembrance, I am telling you the in this fashion. Okay, the traumatic wound and the surgical wound. So this is all about the wound typing. In the next class, we'll go for the wound healing. Okay, this is a very important chapter, wound healing. The wound healing comes as a long question in your examination, in internal or external, or whether any examination, questions will come from wound healing. Okay, so this is all about the wounds. We'll see you in next class. Bye bye, and please like, share and subscribe the video. Share to your friends, okay, so that everybody can know or everybody can learn. Ta-ta.